Now we are passing the new chapter, chapter 5, mass and energy analysis of control volumes. And my first question is, what is control volumes? Or what is open systems? Do you know that?
Hem enerji giriş çıkışı hem de madde giriş çıkışının olduğu kapalı bir sistem.
The first explanation is true, but you said that at the end of the sentence, kapalı sistem. What is it about? What does it mean, kapalı sistem?
Yani okay. Belirli bir çevreyle çevresinden ayrılmış, üzerinde çalıştığımız bölge.
But this system we can say in Turkish, ayrık sistem, not kapalı sistem. Kapalı sistem is, closed system is, only energy transfer is available. In open system, energy transfer and mass transfer is also is available. Okay. Energy is entering with mass and energy is entering with heat and work together. This is open system. Okay. And control volumes is also the open system. And what about the our contents of this chapter? Firstly, you are going to learn that, also I am going to explain that conservation of mass this is the basic. Firstly, we learn that you learn that conservation of the mass. After that, you learn that flow work and the energy of flowing work, fluid. After that, energy analysis of steady flow systems. After that, we are focused on some steady flow engines device, nozzle and diffusers, turbine compressors, throttling valves, mixing chambers, heat exchangers, and pipe and duct flow, and energy analysis for unsteady flow. Do you know that what is steady and what is unsteady? Because here is the unsteady flow and steady flow devices, and here is the unsteady flow process. Do you know that what is the steady flow or what is the unsteady flow?
Sürekli akışta bildiğim kadarıyla bir sirkülasyon oluyor, fakat unsteady'de bir sirkülasyon olmuyor.
It's not like this. Steady flow is time independent flow. Time is not changing. Also, the flow comes steady regime, and after that, flow characteristic is not changing. But in unsteady flow, flow is based on a time, or flow is time dependent. And in every time, flow characteristic can be changed. Also, in the world, we can say every problem is unsteady because there is atmospheric winds comes like this from one direction to the other direction, or one direction to the other direction. Also, boundary condition is also changed because sometimes there is no wind, but sometimes there is very forced wind, we can say. Therefore, in the world, all the processes are unsteady. Now we can look the objectives. Also, what is the aim of this chapter? Develop the conservation of mass principle. In this lesson, we will develop the conservation of mass principle. Also, we determine the what is the conservation of mass principle, and we become or we use some equation of this and apply the conservation of mass principle various systems, including steady state and unsteady flow of controlled volumes. Apply the first law of thermodynamics as a statement of the conservation of energy principle to the controlled volumes. And we make the first of all conservation of mass for steady flow and unsteady flow. After that, we apply the first law of thermodynamics of control volumes. And Identify the energy carried by a fluid stream crossing the control surface as the sum of the internal energy, workflow, kinetic energy, and potential energy. I mean that there is the open flow, our open system. Here is the, for example, heat is entering or get outing, okay, from its boundaries. It's not important. Also, work is come and go, pardon, work its boundaries, but in the open system, mass come here. Also, mass getting out of here. But for the mass, okay, for the fluid, I mean that, the energy is also come here, come enter the system or get out of the system. For flow work, kinetic energy, and potential energy, okay. And solve the energy balance problems, common state flow, such as nozzles, compressor turbines, throttling valves, mixer and heaters, and heat exchangers. And the other objective is apply the energy balance of general unsteady flow process with the particular emphasis of the uniform flow process as well of common and carton change current discharging process. Also, we simplified the, therefore, we simplified the unsteady flow process. Simplified to unsteady process. Okay. Now we look the we pass the conservation of mass. Conservation of mass. Okay, mass like energy is conserved property and it cannot be created or destroyed during a process. Maybe I can explain in Turkish because it's so important. Diyor ki kütle enerji gibi korunan bir özelliktir. Yani hatta çiftleri değil özelliktir. Ve bu yaratılmaz ve yani yok edilemez bir proses esnasında, bir işlem esnasında. Okay. Mass entering the system and mass get out in the system. Therefore, mass is conserved. Conserved. For the situation, okay, during the process or during the, we can say during the process. And what is closed system? The mass of the system remains constant during the process. Mass cannot change, okay, in closed system. But in control volumes, I mean that open system, mass can cross the boundaries, and so we must keep the track of the amount of mass entering the living and entering and leaving the control volumes. Okay. In closed system, mass is constant. Okay. Therefore, mass conserved. But in control volumes, mass can cross the boundaries. And so we must keep track of the amount of the mass entering and leaving the control volumes. Therefore, mass is also conserved in control volumes. Also, you see the chemical reaction here, H2 plus O2 is equal to, I mean, I think this is the 1.2 as far as I know, but in the situation, okay, we can look here and we get the water. Okay, the hydrogen is 2 kilogram, oxygen is, pardon, this is the 1.2, okay. 16 kilogram and total water is the 18 kilogram. Okay, this is the entering masses here. This is the outing masses here. Also, mass is also conserved. Mass is conserved even during the chemical reactions. Also, another mass conservation formulation is was found by Einstein. Mass and energy can be converted to each other. This mass can be converted to energy with the speed of sound in a vacuum. It means 2.99 multiple 10^8 meter divided by second. The mass change due to energy, the mass change due to the energy is negligible. Okay, mass and energy can be converted to each other. But with this velocity, speed of sound in a vacuum, and therefore mass changing, the mass change due to the energy is negligible, because we can say that energy is, we can say a lot of energy is leaving to this system, but in this system, okay, one chat here. What about the düzenlem düzen sıkış? Maybe I look after. There is something. Time passes here, and I look the chat, and the mass change due to energy. Energy change is negligible. Okay. And what about the general formulation of the conservation of mass? Here, inlet mass flow rate. Do you know the what about the mass flow rate unit? Mass flow rate is unit. Maybe you heard first here. Kilogram divided by. Okay, you're right. Kilogram divided by second. Mass balance or mass conservation of the control volume is here. Inlet mass is equal minus outing, getting outing mass or leaving mass is equal to mass changing. Okay. M inlet, M dot inlet, and M dot outlet is the total rate of mass flow into and out of the control volumes. Okay. In mass flow rate of into or the rate of mass flow inlet, the rate of mass getting out of the system, and the MCV control volume divided by DT is the rate of change of mass within the control volume boundaries. Okay, we have mass here, entering here, getting out here, and therefore we calculate the rate of change of the mass. Therefore, mass is conserved. Okay, this formulation is the continuity equation. I'm continuity is the conservation of mass. It is the both of the same. In fluid mechanics, the conservation of mass relation written for a different control volume is usually called the continuity equation. Maybe in fluid mechanics lesson, you use this formulation. After that, you derive or determine the new type of formulation, and this type of formulation is the continuity equation. Okay, but this based off this formulation. This is the really general form of the conservation of the mass equation is here. Okay, after that we look in the detail. And what about then of the conservation of momentum? Okay, linear momentum, the product of the mass and velocity of a body called a linear momentum, or just the momentum of the system. Therefore, they said that the linear momentum is mass multiple velocity is the linear momentum. Okay, and they said that maybe I can explain here, this is so explicitly the next slide, but in Turkish, the next slide is in Turkish. Okay, first of all, we look the acceleration of a body is proportional to the net force of acting on it, and it is inversely proportional to its mass, and that the rate of the change of momentum of body is equal to the net force acting on the body. Okay, first they said that. Also, this is the Newton's second law. They said that this is the linear momentum, but if we pass the force, force is like this, as you know that. Forces of vectoral quantity is equal to mass multiple acceleration. Also in acceleration, F is like this. M divided by dt. Am I true? Also we can write here F is, because if we make that mass is conserved, M is constant. like this. This is the second law or Newton's second law. Okay. After that, what about the conservation of the momentum principle? The momentum of a system, and maybe we can look to this video, and after that we understand what is the m multiple velocity and why the momentum is conserved. Okay, and you see the video. Okay, or can you see the video correctly? And you see the, can you hear the video voice? Please return to, give a feedback to me. Can you see and can you hear the video correctly?
Working, but no voice.
No voice. Really? I can hear. Maybe you open, also you can open the velocity. Maybe I can. In this situation?
Working, okay.
Okay, pardon. Okay, you understand? Maybe I can explain with less voices. Maybe I can explain. And this is explain the what's conservation of the mass. This is, we release two ball and hit the system. After that, the two balls moving the other way. This is the because of the conservation of mass principle. This is the two mass come here with velocity, and the other side two mass leaving the system with the velocity. Okay, because of the conservation of momentum. And when we, maybe you can, maybe you like to play the billiards. You of course think the conservation of the momentum principles. Okay, momentum is mass multiple velocity. Here, for one mass come here with velocity, and the other ball is the other mass and goes to the other way with velocity. Okay, mass one multiple mass two is equal to mass two, pardon, mass one multiple velocity one is equal to mass two multiple velocity two. Here is again the same one ball come here and the other side, only one ball go out. And in this situation, the mess is not equal here because one is the billiards, the other one is the, what is, I don't know, the small mess. And small mess must be, small mess heights or not, velocities must be larger than, because of the small mess small, and velocity must be high, okay, for gaining the velocity to high or small mass, and we can say big mass, big ball, and they said that we must be small, okay, because of the conservation of the mass principle. Yani yüksek bir hızla gelmesi lazım, kan hareket ettirebilmesi lazım. Okay, three comes here and three leaves here. Okay, four comes here and four leaves here. Two. This is related to conservation of the momentum. Okay. And what about the conservation of the momentum principle? This is so important. Please listen carefully. The momentum of a system remains constant. Okay. The momentum of a system remains constant only when the net force acting on it is zero. Therefore or thus, momentum such a system is conserved. Maybe I can explain this one. According to Newton's second law, or we can say the force is equal to like this. Okay. Force is equal to mass multiple acceleration. Also, we can say the acceleration is the force divided by m. Also, the momentum is, also we can calculate the force with the momentum changing with time. Okay. I explain here. Also, this is the same. Okay. Up to now, we know this one. But what about the conservation of principle? Therefore, a momentum is conserved only the force, the acting force, net force is zero to the system. I mean that if the net force O is zero to the system, okay, if this is zero and momentum is constant, changing is constant. Therefore, they said that if the moment is total net force or zero and momentum is conserved. This is the really important issue. Okay, maybe in your academic law, maybe some of yours chosen the academic career, and in academic career, in PhD time or in the other time, all the juries asked these questions basically. In which situation momentum is constant? Also, what is the relation of the conservation of the momentum with force? They said that you can say that if the system, the total momentum of system remains constant only when the net force acting on it zero. I can say that if the net force on the system is zero and momentum remains constant, it means that momentum is conserved. Okay. If the net force is zero and momentum is conserved, therefore force and momentum is related each other. Okay, in linear momentum equation in fluid mechanics, Newton's second law is usually referred as to the linear momentum equation. Okay, also Newton's rules are used in everywhere: solid mechanics, fluid mechanics, also in thermodynamics, and in fluid mechanics. Newton's second law is usually referred to as the linear momentum equation. It means that conservation of the momentum equation. Okay, and this is so important. I'm repeating again. If the network is zero to the system, momentum is conserved, momentum remains constant, therefore momentum is conserved. Okay. And what about the moving and deforming control volumes? Firstly, you don't think this equation. I mean that we are a control volume. Okay, this control volume is moving. And control volume is velocity, is the velocity control volume. But at the same time, flow velocity is the V. Okay, but this is not same each other. This is different between them. Also, this is not equal. Control volume velocity and fluid velocity is not same. But in this situation, we have to determine the one velocity to apply the conservation of the mass. Therefore, we can use the relative velocity, or we can say Boyle velocity in Turkish. Velocity is equal to flow velocity minus control velocity. And let me look to this formulation. This formulation is also the basic formulation of the mass of conservation of the mass. You see here, maybe we can look in detail here. After that, we can look in detail here, but I'm going to explain firstly. The mass changing with time in control volume plus mass entering and outing, getting outing or mass entering and the leaving from the control surface. It means that this is totally control volume and this is the control surface because it's boundary. Okay. Also, you said that mass is entering the control volumes boundary. This is the control surface. And this is the mass changing with time and mass entering and leaving from the mass entering to the system, mass leaving from the system. This is the control volume. And this is the, maybe I can explain, mass changing with time and mass leaving, mass entering to the system or mass leaving from the system. This is the, is equal to zero. Okay. And we can write here, this is the mass changing with time is equal to outing system minus outing mass or leaving mass to the system minus inlet mass to the, or entering mass to the system is equal to zero. In this formulation, we can use relative velocity instead of this velocity, okay? Instead of this velocity, because of the R control volumes moving or deforming control volumes. Also, we can look to some practical problems such as injection of medication through the needle of a shrink by the forced motion during the plunger. Maybe you can, in Turkish, yani şırıngadaki şeyi basmak için ya da bir medikal problemdi. Control volume hareket ediyor. Deforming control volume or moving control volume. But o hareket ettiği moving ile dışarı çıkan su'nun hızı aynı olmayabilir. Bu nedenle relative velocity kullanılabilir. Okay. I mean it in English. Such as injection of the medication through the needle of a shrink by the forced motion of the plunger. Okay, involve deforming control volumes. And in this situation, deforming control volumes velocity is not equal to maybe the fluid velocity. Therefore, we can use the relative velocity. Here, two main equation is given. this is the really method of conservation equation, and the other side is the, this is also the conservation of the mass equation. Okay, now we can look in detail. We have 7 minutes. Okay, firstly, mass flow rate. I'm going to explain mass and volume flow rates. The amount of the mass flowing through a cross section per unit time. This is mass, the amount of mass, maybe I can like here, the amount of mass, okay, per unit time. It is so important. Also, through the cross section is also the important. I mean that mass flow rate, the differential mass flow rate is equal to density multiple normal velocity. Normal velocity is the here, this is for example curved surface or something like that. Normal velocity is the velocity is perpendicular to this control surface, okay, or curved control surface, we can set that. The normal velocity, normal direction of the velocity, and multiple small area, DAC. Therefore, we can look to, maybe I can here delete this, and after that, rho is kilogram divided meter cubic, meter divided by second, and meter square. It means that this going here and the kilogram divided by second is mass flow rate's unit. Okay, unit of mass flow rate is kilogram divided by second. And this is so important, the small area, DAC, and velocity is here. And we have to use the, for explaining or for defining the mass flow rate, we can use the normal velocity. Therefore, this is something angle here, and we can set that normal velocity is cosinus theta. Maybe after that we can see here, not see here. After that we can look the formulation again. Okay, and the AC is the point functions have exact differentials, exact integrals. Maybe we can set that from 1 to 2. The integral for the area, the AC, it means that AC cross section of area is 2 minus cross section of area 1. In the situation, maybe if this is pipe flow and the areas, maybe we can say P, R2 square minus R, maybe not R1, R2 square minus R1 square. Okay, this is maybe for example, cross sectional area is like this. Okay, but PET functions have inexact differentials. Maybe we can, this is the PET functions, Kronecker-Del, they use PET functions as you see, and for make the differential of the PET functions, this is not mass flow rate 2 minus mass flow rate 1. It means that this is total of mass, okay, or system of the mass, we can set that. There is not M2 minus M1, we can set that total of the mass. This is also so important. And we look to, this is the general definition of the mass flow rate. Kronecker delta mass is equal to PET function of the mass is equal to density, velocity, normal velocity, please careful, normal velocity, and small area changing. Okay, and if we make the total mass, we can integrate the mass flow rate. The total mass is equal to, we integrate the, for of course, from the cross-sectional area, rho v and the AC, and we can set like this, mass flow rate is come here, total mass flow rate is from AC and rho Vn and dEc. And this is the general formulation. But if we use the average velocity, mass flow rate is here, but we don't use integral here in this situation. The average velocity is rho, average velocity multiple cross-sectional area. This is also kilogram divided by second. And what about the average velocity? Average velocity is here. For example, we have pipe flow. You don't know this velocity distribution now because you learned in fluid mechanics lesson. But for example, in pipe, the flow distribution, velocity distribution is like this. But we can calculate the average velocity is like this. Average velocity is like this. Total is average velocity is like this. How we calculate the average velocities? Average velocity is 1 divided by cross-sectional area and make integral Vn and Vn dAc. Okay. I mean that we calculate all the velocities, summing of this velocity and the cross-sectional area, small change of cross-sectional area is multiple. And then we make sum of all of it because integral process is like this. And if we divided off this sum term to the EC, we can calculate the average velocity. Okay. And in this situation, maybe I'm going to repeat of this. Mass is like this. The mass flow rate is like this. If we use the average velocity, our mass flow rate is rho, we average and this. And what about the average velocities? We multiply velocity and the cross-section area, small change of cross-section area, and we sum all of this, and if we sum of this, and we can divide it with AC cross-sectional area, and we get the average velocity. Okay, after that, we see in 10 minutes.